This is part of a really long-standing batch of work to begin having murals in Salem. We're going to have this one today. Soon we'll have one across the street and the other side of the parkade. And we're looking forward to it as well. It's part of a process, and you can kind of look down this alley and see what we're thinking about, is opening up our alleys once and for all for particularly pedestrian use and for the variety of opportunities that occur in the alleys and for the preservation of these historic buildings in downtown Salem, which were built in another century for another kind of retailing that really now demands that they be opened on the alley side to make them useful square footage. So we're very excited about it. This project has really been coordinated by the Downtown Advisory Board and the Salem Art Association. And I want to recognize both groups and have them come visit with you. But first, why don't we take a moment and let the curtain drop on this so you can see what we're doing. Spend time thinking about this, what it tells you about, I think, Salem, about our alleys. I'd like to turn this over now to Rick York from the Public Art Commission to talk a little about the process that brought this here. And then Alan, are you going to also speak? Yeah, Alan Turpin from the Downtown Advisory Board, which financed it. So, Rick, do you want to go ahead?
Yeah, thank you, Mayor. Thank you very much. Well, great. And I'd like to really congratulate Damien, not only on kind of completing this piece and getting it all done, but surviving some really brutal 190-degree days of painting out here. So you really kind of, you know, impressed us with your stamina. So, and then I'm proud of the fact that we've actually done this, and this is the first of two. This is the first site-specific commission done by the Salem Public Art Commission, a group of citizens who kind of are trying to bring more art into our community. So it's kind of exciting for all seven of the commissioners who've done that, and I'm proud of the process that we went through. And I'd like to thank Courtney Knox Bush, who is here as our city person, who helped us kind of navigate this process and just with a lot of help and guidance. So Courtney was invaluable in this. So thank you, Courtney. And then all the commissioners that contributed. We worked as a group. I'm proud of the collaboration we had, the transparency that we had, and all the steps we went through. So with that, we hope to activate this alley with even more art. And I think this is a good thing that'll jumpstart it. So I'm really excited about that. I think we should do a cheer for Damien. Yes. Cheer. So I'm going to say, give me an A.
A.
Give me an R.
R.
Give me a T.
T.
What's that spell?
R.
What's that spell?
R.
R.
I'm just here to represent the Downtown Advisory Board, and as many of you know, we just make recommendations to the agency board or the council on funding. A lot of what we do is investing in rehabbing buildings like 1859 Snyder right here. Urban renewal funds available for some of this stuff to happen, and we're also looking at and park. And one of those things is this, murals. So when we were talking about this a while ago, we were all just kind of wondering, well, how much money do you put this, we had no idea. And we just said, well, whatever they're asking, put a little bit more. Because we just wanted to make sure that it was good art and that we got world-class artists. And when we saw the proposals, we were all excited. I've talked to many other of the board members who've come by and seen this, and they love it. It's exactly what we hoped for. Damien is a world-class artist, and it's vibrant and adds color and just life to an area that was really dull, other than the great businesses here. So again, really excited to see it. And over the last couple weeks, I've made a point to kind of walk through the alley and just kind of watch the process and watch Damien do what he's doing. And it was really fun to get to know him. Really great guy. Besides the fact that he does really cool stuff, that you know, he can just create a sense of space just with a line, and create depth and perspective. I've noticed that his art, the longer you sit and take it in, the more interesting things you start to see. That maybe at first it just looks like a little box, but the more you stare at it, you start to see another, oh, there's like a room here, there's space, and this relates to that wall. Anyway, just excited to see it, and I just want to say that it was fun talking with Damien. I noticed, like the mayor said, lots of people walking through here, stopping and talking to him. Even though he's trying to get this done, he would take the time to stop and talk with anyone, and that was really cool. So, Damien, you want to say a few things?
Sure, so I mean, it's what you like. I hope that you find something interesting about it. You know, it's a visually perceptive activated thing. Sometimes like things just need to activate our vision more than tell us a complete story so that people can fill in their own ideas. In the end, I made a lot of these units that kind of look like doors and windows, and then I connected them somewhat erratically with a couple lines. This is like suggesting like walking around the downtown kind of urban area and going from a door to a door to a door to a door. So suggesting like retail and active moving throughout this like urban environment. That's kind of where it came from, and I love looking at it again. I haven't seen it in like a week and a half or something. I think that it's gonna be really nice to see again and again and again and again. Thanks for that comment about when you look at it longer, things will happen. That's usually true about perceptual things. It takes a second. It can definitely be like,
the dog loved it.
Really hold it back. I forgot what I was talking about, but
look at it longer.
Yeah, if you look at it longer, I think that's the idea about the subtleties. Like, hopefully, like, you might walk by and be like, I get it, but then if you look longer, you're gonna be like, okay, I can work with my own mind and perception to activate things a little bit more. So hopefully that will make people possibly look longer at other people.
Too much,
since it's a live spot. Yeah. Yeah. And also, thanks, Mary Lou, for like hosting me.